Sunday and we're all relaxing at home, we're relaxing here. Some of us might be wanting to read a book, and in the background this will just be soothing you as you go along. But we'll just be swearing and popping our clothes off, I expect it. So let's get straight on with the show. Are we ready for some hits and misses? In that case, let's meet the guests who are on this week. First of all, somebody who's worked with David Bowie, Pink Floyd, Janet Jackson. Her group, Blue Pearl, has had many hits themselves. From Los Angeles, California, ladies and gentlemen, Durga McBroom. Secondly, ladies and gentlemen, we've had many, many, many popular times on this show with this next act, we could say that. From that much-loved group, The Cure. All the way from Crawley in East Sussex, is that right?
West Sussex.
Crawley in West Sussex, Robert Smith, ladies and gentlemen. Graciously accepted. You all have seen her in television modernly today. The Late Show, Rapido, Network 7, from Ipswich, Gateway to Cromer, Suffolk, Tracy McLeod, ladies and gentlemen. A new top comedian from Scotland who we'll be seeing much more of, especially during this show, Mr. Craig Ferguson from Glasgow. I see no reason why we shouldn't pop the cassette in and see the first act, which I believe is going to be Jimmy Somerville. To Love Somebody. It was a big hit for Nina Simone and the Bee Gees, written by the Gibb brothers. Craig, may I start with you?
I thought it was fab, Pork Pickles. And it was great that you had his mum in it as well. I think it's great to have your mum in a video singing along with you.
Yes.
And she obviously approves of the haircut, which is a relief to me.
Yes. That's a nice opening gambit. I like that, yes.
Well, I'm not going to endorse any kind of ageist comment. I think it was nice the video looked like it had real people in it.
Yep.
It's a bit of a hard act to follow because that song's been covered, as you say, by Nina Simone and also by Graham Parsons, a country rocker. And I like both those versions. So I found this one a little bit too UB40-ish and a bit flat. But I think it's strange he's moving out of the dance sort of music when everyone else has moved into it. But maybe it's a good thing.
Robert.
This is really difficult. I didn't really like it, I must admit, because UB40 have just been mentioned, and they're not top of my all-time greatest groups list. And Jimmy Somerville, it's sort of like, God bless him, and he does lots of really worthy things and everything, but I've never been a big Jimmy Somerville fan, I must admit, and that wouldn't really convince me.
He has written Remember to Be Nice now on his pad, which I think is really sweet.
Yes, I'm being very nice about it. I thought it was really dreadful. If I was being
nice. Fair enough. Don't mention that.
Durga.
I think it's very nice to see him looking somewhat relaxed for a change.
Yeah.
And it was a nice, easy song. I mean, nothing that really blew me out of the water, but it was very listenable. And the video itself also was a bit generic, but nice to watch as well.
Mm.
So, nice.
Let's, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, vote on the first record. Let's please, Jimmy Somerville, To Love Somebody, is it a hit or a miss? You have those discs in front of you. Display them as you will. Well, there we are. It's a hit, ladies and gentlemen. Oh. And that is clearly the sound. From now on, I just don't even bother talking to the sound man here, but that's clearly the sound he's decided on for a hit this week. Can we hear that again, please, Ian? Thank you. Have you been drinking, Ian? Ian. Good. And what's the sound for Miss this week? Lee? Okay then, Ian. Yep. So let's get on with the next record. I think we'll push this jukebox.
Bitter all my tears that cry forever. Hurt is the heart that will remember. Days gone by when sun and sky were as one, like you and I. We speak no more, we touch no more. My key no longer opens your door. I walk my discontent, I run with my pity, chained by thoughts of how we used to be. A brighter day must shine soon, and in my garden of thought, a new tomorrow must bloom. Reminiscent of the years of happiness, blessed and caressed by the one I suggest, better than the rest. I confess it was a guest appearance in my mind's kingdom, interference. I became a victim, living the life of loving hardcore. Every time she gave, I wanted more, figured out the score. My heart was sore, I had to pick my life up off the floor. Words to borrow, pain and sorrow, words to keep, now it's tomorrow.
Definition of sound, now is tomorrow. And apparently, this might influence what you think of the record. The girl singer, the group found her working in the reception of the recording studio. And there she is. That's what happens in showbiz. Tracy, did you like that?
Well, it was certainly beefy. It sounded like they'd been listening to their De La Soul records a bit too carefully. And I don't really have much of an opinion about it, apart from the fact that I don't really think she was crying. I think someone had come with some tweezers and picked out one of her nose hairs. I don't think it was a real tear.
No, onions were out there.
Onions, no, tweezers, I think.
Tweezers. Robert?
He must know some horrible people to have thought of that. nice things to say about it. I thought her voice was really good, and it had like a really good sort of wimpy sound. If you listen to it on like big speakers, it sort of... But I really... That's the nice things to say about it. I just hate... And that rapping, I really have always hated it, and I haven't really tried to force myself to like it, because what's the point? I just hate it.
Mm. Yeah, there's no point in forcing yourself into it. Yeah.
If she just sang the whole thing, I think I would have liked it.
In a melodic sort of way.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I'm old-fashioned. Mm.
I love a song and a melody. Yeah. Durga, did you like her voice?
Yeah, I think she has a lovely voice. And the thing about the song, though, is it's in that very repetitive sort of unfortunately catchy kind of mode that makes songs do quite well, but is not very exciting. I mean, it just kind of goes on and on and on and on, and the music stays the same in the back, and some guy comes in and raps over it, and then the singing comes, and the music just drones on and on. Mm. So because of that, it'll probably do well, but I don't like it that much.
Craig,
it was fine. It was kind of like every record that you hear on the radio when you're not really listening to it. It's just that stuff that's wallpaper a bit. I believe she was crying.
And it was beefy.
And it was beefy, right. Very beautiful.
Like Desperate Dan sort of thing when you say
that. Yeah, big chins.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cow pie. Let's vote on it, I think, ladies and gentlemen of the jury.
They haven't got one that says beefy here, so.
Oh dear, well, unfortunately it is a... and so, I think one of our guests last week was the singer and writer from the Pixies, and now here he is, being judged himself.
No, my child, this is not my desire. In the I'm digging for fire. I'm digging
and is able to keep awake for the rest of his years. He resides on a beach in the town where I am going to live. And I often ask him, are you looking for the mother lode? No!
Oh. Interesting that the Ugly Mob seemed to quite like that. A lot of sidecars in that as well. Robert, did you...
I really like the Pixies. I think they're one of those groups that's got it. Everyone in the group sort of knows what they're doing, and they don't really overstate what they're doing. I was a bit dubious about the video. I really don't like those things that people put in their heads to sing so they can wave their arms about.
Yes.
But put in context of like getting into the sidecars of very dodgy Dutch Hells Angels, I suppose it all makes perfect sense.
Yes, they were dodgy Dutch Hells Angels, weren't they?
They were very dodgy Dutch Hells Angels.
They had sidecars because they couldn't stand up.
It sounds really good, and that's sort of my kind of dance music.
Right, good.
I think the one shot in that video that I really liked was that slow fade into where the motorcycles, the sidecars appear. I thought that was really cool, and the rest of it was okay. The song itself, I think, is really... I like the song. I like what they do in it. Unfortunately, I think that it might be a little bit too ahead of its time.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
So can that.
And I would like to see this do well. I'm not sure if it will.
Mm. Craig.
I'm not surprised that Robert liked it, because it sounds like the boys in this band will be listening a bit to Robert's pop group for a wee while. To be
well, he was on last week, and he liked Black Francis. On, he loved Robert. He was a very nice bloke.
I'm sure he is. I think he's taken a lot of what his pop group does from Robert. That's all. And I quite like the fact that there was obviously a receptionist in this one as well, because you see them strapping on this stuff.
Yes.
Obviously, because it was only Chikorita.
Chicory Tip.
Yeah, they weren't receptionists, but they are now.
Right. Yes. Son of your father, I think, was a
son of my father,
was
I think, Jones.
Right,
yeah, son of my father.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What an irritating record that was. But we're not here to discuss that right now, Tracy.
Well, I thought it was interesting that Durga should say it was ahead of its time, because in a way it's kind of old-fashioned in that it uses real instruments and real drumming rather than, you know, that kind of computerized, relentless beat that most records that get in the charts seem to have. So in that way, I don't think it ever would get in the charts, which is a shame, because they're obviously a band where when you listen to them, you know there's something going on. I think they're a good band, but I don't think it would be a hit.
Let me ask you then, please, to vote. The Pixies, Dig for Fire, hit or a miss?
We'll vote. To influence people,
yeah,
shall we?
Yeah, yeah. You can influence people. Yeah. And it is... hit. On Vogue, ladies and gentlemen, You Don't Have to Worry, a brand new single, their first single, I think. There we are, on Vogue, You Don't Have to Worry. Did you like that?
Oh. I
did say that it was their first single. Of course it isn't. It isn't. I was getting confused with somebody else. I was head-deep with the cakes and everything. They've had a big hit. One of them is the former Miss Black America, I believe. There you have it. Craig, did you like that?
More receptionists.
No, yes! No receptionists there.
Yeah, there was receptionists. They were real receptionist things. Yes! More receptionists doing well when Chicory Tit haven't changed their image and gone with the flow, man. I think it's great that receptionists are doing so well in the pop charts, or maybe not, I don't know, but they were great. I thought, well, not really, it's kind of so what.
Tracy.
Well, they're one of these sort of manufactured new wave of girl groups, aren't they, in America? I don't really know that much about them. There seems to be something very weird going on in the video with lots of stamen and things like that. Obviously sexual symbolism, but I don't really have much of an opinion about it. It's that kind of Jam and Lewis sound, really, that either you love it or you hate it.
Robert.
The backing vocals on that made it really good. They actually, the girls on there sounded like they were enjoying singing, and despite everything, I wish I hadn't seen the video, because I've heard that a couple of times, and I thought it was, I wish they'd done a video that didn't have them in black and white all sort of going, and again they've got like the stupid things where they can do this with that. It's like they should be working with Tim Pope, they'd be good, because they've got really good voices, and it's a pretty dull and dumb song and stuff, but there's something about them, I don't know, I don't like them, but I thought that was all right.
Dada?
I think that those girls are very talented. They sing so well together. I was singing, you know, hold on to your love.
I thought that was
in there, and it's like, I was just doing that because you could interchange the two. The DJs will love it because you can just switch them, you know. And I think they can do a lot better.
Said it on Vogue. You don't have to worry. Was it a hit? Is it a miss?
Can you do that?
No.
Can you do this?
You really have to.
Wish it weren't.
It was a hit, ladies and gentlemen. Very sad. As you voted in, you can all have some lovely... your mic cable isn't there. You can all have some of these. We've had mushrooms, we've had space cake, and this week we've got some sweeties. So here's a bit of heavy metal, I expect. Let me start with you.
Well, a dirty job. I think there's been quite a long queue down at the job centre for that kind of job. I don't know why they were all wearing those gas masks. I'm sure they get pretty sweaty with that kind of activity, but I didn't really see it. Couldn't really see it. This seems to be a question with heavy metal videos of what you can get away with now and how far you can get with those little subliminal shots of people's buttocks and things waving around in front of the camera. It's all a little bit unnecessary, if you ask me.
Mm. Robert?
Well, I was really trying to be nice.
You don't have to be.
And it's rats with a silent P, and I hope they're the special guests as well.
Yeah.
Ah, listening to this is a dirty job, but this is so typical. It's so typical, it's boring. Everybody in America that gets into this kind of music makes music like this. There's nothing special about this song. There's nothing special about this band. I don't like them. I don't like this video.
Well...
I thought it was great. I thought it was great. It's a joke, obviously. It's obviously a joke.
No.
Ah, it's great. It's Spinal Tap. It's Spinal Tap. What's wrong with being sexy? Sexist, Nigel, is it? It's a joke. It's a joke.
The what?
The sad thing about this video is that it's not a joke.
No.
If this were a joke, like Dave Lee Roth's video stuff, they would be great. But they take themselves too seriously, I'm sorry.
Is it a hit or a miss?
Quick.
It's a unanimous... I think the crowd appreciated that. So, moving along quickly, and I think we've got EMF. EMF, ladies and gentlemen, unbelievable. Well, please view to the mob like that. What about the jury? Craig?
No, I thought it was great, and I really like... Yeah, it was good. They did something funny with chords.
It was good, that bit.
Yeah, I like that. It went down and you thought it was going to go up and it went down, didn't it?
Good chords.
Yeah, and you know, because you do that.
Tracy, did you like that?
Well, I'd say the word beefy again if I didn't think Craig would just copy me. But I think it's you know, definitely the best song we've heard so far. No, it sounds, you know, it's got a little bit of everything thrown in and it sounded really good.
Robert?
It looks like it'd be good fun to be in them.
Yes.
You know, they've got that, but and anyone that wears Vision streetwear has got to be halfway all right. I don't know, some of it's a bit mannered, but it's a great underneath sound again. It's like all sort of woomphy again. Don't know, yeah, I was tapping my feet.
Yeah, well, you get too close.
Who knows? Who knows?
Yes, me. I really find them boring, to tell you the truth.
Wasn't it ever
too? Sorry, I do. They did do that nice little chord progression in the chorus, which I thought was a nice attempt to lead it out of sounding like about six other songs that I could think of. But I ain't into them. But I do think it will do well.
Do you think it'll do well, huh?
Just one thing. I think I'd be a bit dubious if this is their first single. I wouldn't have it as my first single.
Would you not want?
Well, because they're opening themselves up for all that sort of criticism, which is quite true. It isn't different enough to be a first single. But having said that, they look as if they're really like enjoying it. They've got that sort of. They look like they've got that in the group. So if they get as far as like a third single, they'll probably do something that's a lot better.
But don't you think if you're looking at sitting on this panel and they're on the telly and it's their first single, you can't start thinking, well, okay, let's see their third single. I mean, it's their first single, so let's look at their first single and say, yeah, it's good.
Well, only if they don't have any intention of making a third single, then I accept that.
What? Shut up. They're shouting outside over there. Anyway, it was a good different chorus. Overall, all I can ask you is to vote, please, on EMF. Unbelievable. Well, it's a hit, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm very pleased to say that now this week's mystery guest. Yeah. Are you there? Everybody was perfectly nice, as I said they would be. Oh, hello.
Hi, Jules.
Hello, well done. Is he your hero? There you go, then. Thanks for coming on. EMF, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, sorry. Here, add this. There's, there we are, the shaping of the modern world. There you go.
Oh, great.
Cheers. Wow. It was worth coming on.
It's a good job you didn't say much stunts, but you'd lost another job.
Yeah. Thank you.
I heard that.
Did you? Right then. Oh, take it to that fridge. Cake's all right?
Wonderful.
Oh,
would you like a bit of sweets up there, Craig?
Please.
I just try, you know, I try to keep it simple. Oh, nearly gone off the end.
Thank you.
There we are. So anyway, Wycliffe and Love Speak Up is next.
We're talking about love.
There we are, Wycliffe, Love Speak Up. Do you like that? Well, he's 21, he's from Nottingham, and it's his first single. Durga, what did you...
This song grows on you, actually. I mean, I've only heard it, this is the second time I've heard it, and I actually like it more than the first time I heard it. It makes me sad to think that he's going to run up against innumerable comparisons to Terence Trent D'Arby because of the way he sings. He's got a great voice, though, you know, on its own. Mm. And I really like the vocal arrangements. I think the video and the song could have gone a little bit farther. I mean, it sounded like it was a good start, and they could have put more into it. But as it is, I think it's good. And I hope people like it.
Yes. Robert.
It's, I don't know. It's sort of damning for me to say that it doesn't mean anything to me. It's one of those sort of songs. There's like lots and lots and lots of music that I don't really like and that just goes on, and lots of people do like it. And this is probably one of those things. I mean, being compared to Terence Trent D'Arby, is, for me, it would be a really damning criticism because I think he's awful. This wasn't as bad as Terence Trent D'Arby for me, but seeing the video, there's nothing happens. It's like you can't be that serious and be that, expect people to take you that serious and expect people to care if you haven't done anything before. I mean, I know he's done lots of things before then because he's 21 years old, but you don't know that, and it's too much to expect.
Yes. Tracy?
Wasn't you playing the piano on that, was it?
No, it was a sampled piano.
No.
I could tell you this.
Sample piano?
Yeah, yeah. And it didn't sound very good.
But there was a bloke in the video playing it?
Just as a piano, as on piano sounds. Not that we're reviewing that. I didn't think it was very good, but
no.
There you are.
Well, thank you for the expert witness on that. I thought he had a good voice again, and obviously he does sound like Terence Trent D'Arby. And I sort of agree with Robert, really, about the kind of reverential way he's being handed to us, and you can imagine the sort of hype that will go around the guy as it's his debut single, that he's the next big thing, and they'll present him in this very solemn way as if he's an incredibly mature artist and all that. We just have to see what he'll do.
Craig?
I thought it was great. I can't kind of say that I really, maybe I'm too, you know, I've seen too many videos on the telly and everything, but I just watched it and thought, well, there are some guys in a nice church, which is lovely. And, I thought it was really good, actually. And they weren't acting or anything. It's just, you know what you're like when you're 21, you sing a song, you want to be quite serious about it.
Until I saw this board, I thought his name, I thought it was Wycliffe.
Yeah. Oh, you're so existential, no, Robert.
Because it doesn't fit what he looks like in the video, and I thought, what an excellent note. That's why I was expecting a video that's like Wycliffe. I thought, when's it going to happen? Mm. When's someone going to like fall through the roof onto him?
Yeah. It's
like,
yeah. But there were no
and he would say, Wycliffe.
Yeah. there were no questions, just answers in the video, really, yeah. Weren't there? I think, yes. Well, thank you for your lovely opinions. Could I have your voting system, please? Oh, it's level bevels even, Stephen. So we throw it to the mob rule, then. It's ready. Thank you, Ian. Yes, lovely. The mob, first of all, did you like it?
No!
Well, it's not up to you. It's up to these three selected members here. It is a hit, ladies and gentlemen. What was your favourite video and song, Durga?
Oh, God. You know, my favourite thing was the introduction to the show.
Courtney Pine.
You know, with the blue nails and the yeah, eyeshadow. That's my favourite.
Courtney Pine, yeah.
Can I say that?
Yep.
That's my favourite.
Courtney Pine will hopefully be listening. He did the music and there. Good.
My favourite.
That's not fair. Can I pick a different programme then?
Yeah, sure. Absolutely. That's what we like to hear, yeah.
No, I won't pick that. I honestly don't think any of the videos were. Like, a couple of the songs were all right, but I think the videos were dreadful all in all.
I think
tonight.
You're right. On the whole, the
They're
standard
dull.
Of videos are appalling, aren't
dull.
They?
Dull. Very, very dull. And I so I'll abstain from that. They were
well,
all
what
you...
songs did you like then?
I thought that EMF had a bit of life to it, and I thought that On Vogue was good as well.
Tracy?
Yeah, I kind of agree about the videos. I think the EMF video and song were definitely the best just because it was unpretentious. It was just them in performance having a good time and they weren't like arty shots of sidecars going into the dusk and all that.
Craig?
I thought the EMF one was best. I liked the video as well and I thought it was okay. And I'm looking forward to seeing the third single and hope I can be back to judge on it then.
Mm-hmm. Well, ladies and gentlemen, please a big hand for all of our fantastic guests, Mr. Craig Ferguson. Our land of fantasy with all of the hits and stuff next week. Goodbye.